He was forgiven. And he said that not only will I forgive you, I won't even remember it anymore. He says, as far as the east is from the west, that's been removed. The sins don't even exist once I forgive them. But you know what? We just want to, sometimes we want to dissect the scriptures, and we either want to come up with some reason why they won't apply to our lives. Or maybe we do apply them, and we just want to take part of it. Okay, so you said confess. I'll do that, Lord. Okay. You said you'll forgive me. Okay. I guess I'll accept that. But you can't have the God forgave you without, and he will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. They go together. You just can't separate it. Hallelujah. And when God was bringing this to me, he gave me an example, and I'm going to use my relationship, me and Donnell. Donnell, some of you don't know that Donnell and I grew up across the street from each other. So we kind of know each other pretty well. We've experienced some of the same experiences. We know each other very, very, very well. Hallelujah. And we were best friends before we ever got married. Praise God. And that's a good thing. Hallelujah. And we're still best friends. Hallelujah. And we take the time. Remember I told you to take time to talk to God? We take the time to talk to each other. We walk together. We talk together. We pray together. We believe together. Hallelujah. We struggle sometimes together. Hallelujah. We're going for the same goal together. And because we do all this stuff together, you know, I come trusting. I know that he would never, ever, ever do anything to hurt me. Now, having said that, has he ever hurt me? Has he ever hurt my feelings? Yeah. I mean, being the human that he is, he can sometimes kind of put it out there a little rough. Y'all kind of get that. We kind of get that. He can put it out there. Hallelujah. But when he hurts me and he realizes that he has hurt me, she asks me to forgive him. And I do. Praise God. But you know what? It doesn't stop there. Me forgiving him is not enough. He's got to accept my forgiveness. And when you ask God to forgive you, when you confess your sins and he forgives you, if you keep going doing that same thing over and over and over again, you haven't accepted his forgiveness. And when Donnell, he accepts my forgiveness, when I forgave him and he accepted it, that empowered him to make the decision to never do that thing to hurt me again. Sometimes, remember I told you he didn't go intentionally hurt me. When that came out of his mouth, he didn't know it was going to hurt me. Praise God. He wasn't intending to hurt me. Hallelujah. But when he realized that that thing hurt me, he never ever goes back and does that again. And because I have forgiven him, I can't hold it against him. I can't hold it against him because it ain't there. Because as far as the east is from the west, it's been removed. And so when I'm looking for that hurt, it's gone. And that's the way it is when we go to God and ask him to forgive us. As far as the east is from the west, the reason we can boldly come before his throne of grace and not die in his presence, hallelujah, not have to be pulled out of the sanctuary, you know, like the priest did when they didn't get it all right, it's because he has forgiven us. And when we accepted his forgiveness, that sin was removed. It's not there no more, so he don't see sin when he looks upon it. Glory to God. But you've got to accept his forgiveness. Hallelujah. You've got to unload all that stuff that's holding you down and get rid of all that guilt that makes you think that God can't bless you. Hallelujah. All that stuff, even if you did do it, if you've confessed it and you've accepted his forgiveness, it's as if you never did it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. S is for serve. And you know, sometimes you think it's just praising God, you know, serving Him, coming in and worshiping Him and serving Him, and that is part of service, but that's not all there is to it. Serving Him is obeying Him. He says in His Word that obedience is better than sacrifice, and to hearken better than the fat of rams. He wants us to obey Him. Serving Him is obeying Him and hearkening into His Word and doing what He told us to do. One of the things He told us to do in His Word, and the main, this is our great commission, is to go therefore and teach all nations.
Amen.
Hallelujah. To go and teach the law. To teach them. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy 2:24 through 26 says, "And the servant of the Lord must not strive, but be gentle to all men, apt to teach." We're supposed to go teach. We're supposed to be patient. "Instructing those that oppose themselves." Glory to God. He told us to do this, and yet we are saying, "Lord, I can't do that. I'm not worthy." That is for Pastor Donnell and Pastor Hill and Sister Hill and Sister Denise. You know, that's for them. It's not just for them, it's for us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He didn't say, single it out and say, if you have been appointed to be a pastor, go teach.
That's right.
It's something that He told us all to do. Praise God. And in serving, you know, it's not so much that He needs us to do these things. God can make it happen just like that. But you got to understand there's a principle in service. I remember years and years ago, back when the bakery was open, you know, you're dealing with people sometimes, and some people are hard to please. Hallelujah. You're dealing with all kinds of circumstances. At the time, they were building the university, and traffic, you know, wasn't coming up the street like it needed to be for business to thrive. And sometimes you could get frustrated, you know, and all that's going on. And I remember times when I got so frustrated that I'd leave there crying. And my daughter was at Mother Calls. He kept her there. And I would go to Mother Calls to pick up my daughter. And while I was there, I just said, you know, Mother Calls, you look tired. I'm going to wash these dishes for you. And it was amazing that after I washed those dishes, that frustration was gone. And God was trying to teach me a principle there. He says, if you serve me, hallelujah, it's for your benefit. Hallelujah. Love is the only thing that you can give away as much as you want to, and if you'll never run out. And the more you give, the more it keeps coming back. You can't give away enough love that you don't have it back in your life. Hallelujah. I remember I lost my job. Daniel and I both lost our jobs in 2004. And you know, when things like that happen, you know, there's the tendency to somewhat worry, except that because we had taken the time in the Word and our faith was built up, we knew everything was going to be all right. But at the same time, we knew something's got to happen so we can eat tomorrow. And all. And at the time that I lost the job, you know, and Satan will try to come in and tell you, what are you going to do? And family members are all worried about you doing, and they're trying, you know, if they're meeting well, but they're trying to put that doubt on you that this ain't going to be all right. Hallelujah. And they're not doing it intentionally. They love you. Hallelujah. But Satan will get in anywhere he can to try to make you discouraged and keep you from getting what God has, the fullness of there. And that comes to, I don't know what number I'm on, but this is another reason.